Nate Oates joins us here on the Rich Eisen Show. How are you, Coach?
Good. How are you guys doing?
I'm doing fine. So when you got back to your room or your phone, how was it blowing up for you?
I shut it off during the game. When I turned it back on, it gives you the blue thing next to the unread. It didn't even, like, all these unread texts didn't even have the blue thing next to it. I think I broke my phone. I don't know what. I still got, like, I think I got 273. I'm not even trying to return them all. I made sure I returned my mom and dad's and a few close friends, and the rest of them can wait till this thing's all done.
So the blue number was 273? Is that what you're saying?
That's what it was. But then I've returned a few here and there. Obviously, some coaches text me that can help me out in Kentucky, so I make sure I get back to them. But, there's way too many. It got a little nuts.
And is it true that to make sure that your team, which now must focus on the next page, the next team, and it's no less than Kentucky, that to make sure they focused on it, that you removed their phones from their possession. Is that a true story?
Yeah, I did. I just knew. I mean, this isn't our first time in the tournament. It's our first time winning the game. Mm-hmm. So even just getting to the tournament, I told them, you're going to have kids you haven't heard from in 4 or 5 years trying to act like they're your buddies now, and you're going to have a million texts. And so listen, go enjoy it for an hour and a half, too. We took them at 12:30. The game got done around, I think, 10-ish out here or something like that. Mm-hmm. So we gave them a couple hours, and then we took them, and we didn't have breakfast till 10. So they all got 8-plus hours of sleep, and we can be rested. But we gave them back. We charged them for them. We gave them back. They're free now for about an hour. I told them, go ahead and return as many texts as they can, and then let's get locked back in when we go back and do video again this afternoon.
Okay, before we get to turn the page, let's go back. What did you guys see? What did you and your staff see that you could exploit against Arizona that you guys performed so well?
I thought they played the 2 7-footers, so they're spacing, and Sean Miller's an unbelievable coach, and so he's going to use his personnel the best he can. And having 2 7-footers, you obviously got to punch in the post all the time. But they were 312th in the country in percentage of points coming from three. So we were going to super heavy load up in the lane and make them shoot more threes than they want and keep the ball out of the post. But their spacing's a little tight when you got 2 7-footers in there, so it made it a little bit easier. Then the other thing is, like, everybody in the Pac-12, I mean, most of the teams zoned them. There's a few that tried to man them, but I didn't think anybody really got into their guards heavy with a lot of ball pressure. And we've got, in my opinion, two of the best defensive guards in the country, and Dante Carruthers and Devontae Jordan, and I thought they could blow up their guards and make it really hard to enter the ball in the post when we're fronting the post, and they did that. And I just, everybody's telling us, if you got a zone in, this would be the game to use it. Well, we don't have a zone in, really. I mean, I put one in the preseason, never used it one time. Now is not the time to start doing what you don't do. I thought we could really shrink the floor and take away their post game. And then on our offensive end, they were going to have a really hard time guarding us, which showed up. I mean, Jeremy Harris went by 8 and, like, at will. And they Perkins was able to drive wrist stitch. They really just couldn't guard us with all that size on the floor, the way we spread the floor out.
And, we couldn't help but notice that, in the halftime interview on TV, you said, we're the better team. And that caught a lot of people's attention. Coach?
Maybe I shouldn't have said it. I don't know. But I really felt – I still felt like that. Like, I knew going in we had a chance. We were going to have to make some threes, and they were going to have to miss some threes, and we needed to out-rebound them. And we couldn't turn the ball. That was the frustrating thing with me is we had 9 turnovers at the half, where we had 2 games in our conference tournament where we only had 8 turnovers for the game. I felt like if we had, if we only had 3 or 4 turnovers, we might have been up 10 at that point. Knowing that going into the half, I really felt like we should have been up by a lot more, and I was a little frustrated, and I felt like we were the better team with the game plan we had and based on what was going on. And if we corrected a few things, I thought we could blow that thing open in the second half, and that's what ended up happening.
The Rich Eisen Show, weekdays at noon Eastern on Audience.